Wait, no, that's too quick. Let's slow that down. Let's. Ah, shit.
Don't I feel loved? Alright, y'all expected me to come out here today and talk about what happened last weekend in Genesis, and I won't disappoint you. However, first, I'd like to announce that the owner of UCW, Vega Ayano, and myself have had some rather productive conversations lately about the path of Universal Championship Wrestling. That being said, it was ultimately decided and can be made official that UCW management will now be allowed into the ring as competitors. That's okay. Each member of management now has the ability, and even some of them have it pre-written into their contracts, to represent UCW in every capacity. Which brings me to my next announcement, because in exactly 1 week's time, Xander Garcia himself, the president of UCW, will be booked in his ring debut on Breakout. Now, to address what happened last weekend to me. I could come out here and rage or cry that Izzy Bomb attacked me, but let's be honest. That's exactly what I wanted from her. It was just her proving that she is everything she's always been. Now, I won't fire her. I'll do one better. I'll wait her out. Because I know she sees it now. I know that she feels who she is in her blood. Who every one of you knows who she is. That's who she's meant to be. It's just a matter of time now. And I have plenty of time where that comes from. I wouldn't say that's a coward's tactic. I guess you'll have to wait and see too.
I don't know what to say to that. I'm going to leave it right there, and we will just see how official those words are in the times to come. Now, let's just move on. We are going into the next match. Hailing from Woodford, South Carolina, standing 6 feet, 1 inch tall, weighing 229 pounds, this is John Rhodes. his opponent, hailing from Las Vegas, standing 6 feet, 3 inches tall, weighing 240 pounds, this is the Playboy, Chip and Dale. Are in the ring. We got a Jamie in the ring. All right, we're rolling strong here. We are rolling strong. Jamie's going to check them both out. Looks like they might be good to go.
Jamie got a new hairdo. I like it. You're mad at me, aren't you? I like it when you're mad at me.
Oh, no. I don't get mad. I get even. Now, Jamie is all but good to go here. My brother squared off. There's the bell, and we are underway. The Playboy first, the center of the ring, not even hesitating, and there's a lockup. Good collar and elbow, and oh, arm drag from the Playboy sends John Rhodes over. John getting up. Rather spiritedly. Oh, and he finds himself in a wrist lock from the Playboy. The wrist lock cranking it around to wrench it, twist it, turn him all the way over. Got it locked in tighter. See how he grabs the shoulder there for extra leverage. A little bit of extra pain there. He's going to grind it in just to make you feel it. He's gonna make you feel that ouch. That's right, Spencer. He's going to make you feel the ouch. John's trying to fight out of it, but Playboy going on his recent run of showing his evolution, that he has improved drastically. He's going beyond just the innuendos, and oh, a nice arm snap, proving that point then some, how he can hold that wrenched wrist lock in tighter. Hold it for a while and then snap the arm. There you go. That's how you evolve. Picking John up, going to the ropes, and no! John with the rebound back elbow, telling Chip John is here to play.
You know that John just got cleared for in-ring action, right?
And yes, it shows there. Going in for just a one count. It's going to take a hell of a lot more than that to keep the Playboy down. And since Mack trucks are not allowed in the match, let's see if John can find it. Ooh, nice kick to the gut, chop across the clavicle, and then just a pop right to the face. Oh, but Playboy throwing fists, lefts and rights. Got down a little days. John tried to kick him, but Playboy catches it. Oh, sweeps out from under with a beautiful dragon screw. John holding his leg there, and Chip poising him into position, going right for another body part there. That's good. Playboy's working the biology of John Rhodes here. He's going to fling John into the corner there. John hitting it unceremoniously hard as Chip comes in, but staring him down.
Oh! Those knees right up into the under the rib cage, into all that soft tissue, and just pounding away. Look at him being lifted up off the mat, and another one, just for good measure. John dropping to a seated position, and Playboy backing up. I thought Playboy was setting up for one of his funnily named signatures, but no. Chip is very serious here. Chip means him some business. Chip keeping John poised into position here, getting to the center of the ring. Hooks up, rolls, a nice cradle maneuver. One, two. Oh, nope, Jamie says that John got his shoulder up a little bit. Oh, and then finally slips out of it. Only a two count. And no, I am not even going to argue what the name of that move is. It's just a simple cradle. I'm just going to call it a cradle maneuver. Chip poising John into position here again. Oh, looks like John maybe... Oh, there he goes. John gets the hand on the back and flings Chip towards the... towards the ropes, coming off the ropes. A one-night stand hitting John square in the face. Yes, John got hit by a one-night stand. You got to be careful about those one-night stands. You don't need to get violent with it. Chip posing into position here, going to fling John off the ropes now. John coming back. Oh, rebound, wheel kick. How many rotations did he do in midair? I lost count after two. The Playboy is down. John is slower to get up than normal, but John is showing plenty of heart here. Looks like John's going to get right up in there. He is not hesitating, and he is not afraid. And John flinging Chip towards the ropes. Chip coming back, and a sick kick right to the mush. Oh, that was boot to teeth. Ouch.
Even my face hurts after that.
John's going to be feeling that one in the morning. That is for certain. Now Chip rarely, having, if ever, shown fear, he's getting right up there. He's staying on John. That's a good thing. Going to get him in a front face lock here. He's got the head there. He's got the inside arm. All right, that's a really good face lock right there. Wait a minute. He's got them both hooked. Down and... Oh! Driven hard. Put away wet. There's one, two, and three. No? Just two? Holy shit! I have seen Chip put a few opponents away with that one. But John kicked out of it. Bravo, John. It took a lot out of John to kick out of that, as you can see it, while Chip poised him into position. John favoring his back, like his whole back. Chip flinging John to the corner. And John just collapses against the turnbuckles. But no, John's back up. And a running face wash. This is what I thought he was setting for up earlier. Looks like he's setting up something here again. This might be it. He's backed up. And Chip charging in, but no! John rolls out of the way! Deep throat to the turnbuckle. Nada feels good. Nada feels good. Oh, the Playboy is holding his Chip. Oh, kick in the face. A nice round over enziguri. Chip is dazed. He may be hearing birds and stars tweeting.
Nothing wrong with that.
Oh, chops across the chest. Oh, John is getting in there. Wait a minute. John lifting the leg. He's going to wrap it over the rope, and he's grinding away. I just love watching those. That's my favorite wrestling move right there, the monkey flip. My absolute favorite right there, the monkey flip. Oh, and John indeed hits Chip with the monkey flip. Yes. A monkey flip on Chip. How wonderful is that to say? Now John poising Chip into position here. Let's see if John can keep the control down, because I know firsthand and full well that right there, you can't keep Chip down for too long. Oh, and Chip hitting John with the dropping the big D. Chip dropped the big D right there. And I'm just kind of wiggling, just kind of squirming in place. Oh no. Oh goodness. Wait a minute. He's got him picked up. Oh, and here he goes. Now Chip whipped it out and he swung the big D, flinging John right back to the mat hard. Oh. The Playboy is putting on a clinical there in the ring.
It's probably the worst description of something I've ever heard in my life. I agree with everybody booing.
Oh, John coming off the ropes. Chip grabs him, catches him, and down he goes into a penetration achieved. Yes, penetration achieved in the ring. Okay. Chip poising John into position here. I don't think John has anything left, folks, at this point. But, you know, guy has heart. I'll give him that. John coming off the ropes. Chip catches him. Oh, picks him up for the just been violated. Oh, now Chip just yanking John to his... I don't even want to say it, but wait a minute! Wait a minute! We got a small package! There's one, two, and three! Wait, Jamie, I'm going to need an official call on that. Who won?
I think Chip's surprised.
Whoa! John won? Ladies and gentlemen, your winner via pinfall, John... Oh, come on!
twists and turns all around here at Universal Championship Wrestling. We are also going to... Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, let's kick this off.
Robbed of my undefeated streak in submission matches by none other than Arnie Blunt. I got put into his crossface and the referee decided that I had passed out, that I couldn't answer the call, and so my streak was over. To make things worse, our contracts were on the line, which meant that the loser had to leave the company. Now, I lost, I left, even though it was a very controversial lose, as Honey Blunt, the woman you, the fans, loved so much to cheer on, used a metal bat to knock me out before she applied the cross. Yes, the referee didn't see it, though no excuses were made by my side, as I had at home. I packed my bags and I left the United States of America. But don't think that that my fellow Japanese wrestlers put out a welcome sign for me. I was as filthy to them as the guy Jin's, who, when they would enter for the first time our country. My career was built on the things I did in America, and they meant nothing. Nothing. I had to start again. I had to rebuild myself, become stronger, faster, more lethal than ever before to prove my worth in their eyes. Fast forward 1 week ago, nearly 4 years in the making, Honey Blunt got what she deserved. A dose of reality, but she could never beat me in a submission match, let alone in a normal match without underhanded tactics. Honey Blunt, listen. Last week was a small sample what I have in store for you and everyone who joins your cause. A fair warning from my side. But, as they say, it's a new day, it's a new beginning, a new show, a new victim. So bring out the person who dares to step in the ring with me.
Answering the call.
I'm not interested in facing you again tonight. Like I said, it's a new day, a new opponent, and you're not new to me.
Wait, what? Ladies and gentlemen, Emma Gray! We'll be right back. welcome.
She's got a microphone. I wonder if she's going to talk.
Holy wow. I thought the surprise was going to be another time, but that's Emma for you, ladies and gentlemen. So violent. Emma's just staring into the room from the outside here. She's got something scouted here, and Emma has quite a bit of history and quite a bit of stake at what's going on in the ring, the two inside the ring. Honey being accompanied by Crystal over on the side there, the lovely Crystal, and nope, now Emma's in the ring. Emma, good gal, but she does tend to, she tends to pace things out beautifully. I gotta say, Arizona, Emma, wait a minute.
Emma says, honey, we've had our history, and of course you're out here again taking time away from people. Got another lackey in your corner. Not surprising, you've had plenty.
Ooh. Ouch. Oh, now Emma going right up to Misaki, not even hesitating, just staring her down.
As for you, Misaki, we haven't been introduced, so let me make it simple. I'm Emma Gray.
Oh, and a smack! Shots fired! Wait a minute. Emma and Misaki have never met before.
Emma calling for a ref.
And a ref she shall get. So let's see if I can get some of this chaos under control here. Symbol went in the room. All right, well, first out. She hails from Tokyo, Japan. She stands 5'7" tall, weighing 148 pounds. Lady closest to my right in all black. That is Misaki Yumako. That's right, folks.
Yay!
If you don't know who that is, then welcome to your very first day of seeing SL Wrestling. And the second lady out, that hippie, trippy chickie there with light blue, she's got the yellow, you see her clear as day. She hails from homegrown USA, standing 5'8" tall, weighing 135 pounds. That is the Honey Blunt! And making her Universal Championship Wrestling debut. She comes from Belfast in Northern Ireland. She stands 5'3" tall. She weighs 110 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Emma Gray! And I gotta say, the blonde hairs throwing me out, but I think this is the first time I've seen her blonde, but it's really working for her. It's just gonna take me a little bit to adjust to. But it's really, really going great for her. Jamie trying to keep control in there, but like I said, there is a ton of history. There is a ton of just story between the three ladies there. I don't even know where to begin. Oh, Honey. Honey's getting a little antsy in there. Look at her. She's kind of hyper today. She's ready. Do you need me checking out on Crystal? Yeah, Crystal's good. Crystal's fine out there. Crystal's not doing anything. And there's the bell. This one is officially underway. Misaki going right in the middle of both. And a Yakuza kick to Honey. Oh, just blatantly and mean. Oh, Misaki turns around and catches Emma with a drop toe hold. Misaki's vicious. Misaki grabbing Emma by the hair, lifting her up, and now she's got a rear naked choke applied. Emma trying to get her arms up there, trying to break the hold, but Misaki, being an extreme ring expert, wait a minute, Emma lowering her center of gravity, getting that snapmare into place, flipping Misaki over. Now that's how you get it back in control. Emma trying to get her lungs in her air, get some air in her lungs again. That's why she's standing there kind of rigid, kind of stiff. That's the best way to get oxygen back into your lungs. Misaki on the ground, but not for long as Emma poises her into position. Misaki not having that. A nice shove and an elbow strike. Oh, another elbow strike, catching Emma on the side of the face. Now they're backing up Emma Honey, who is still feeling and reeling from the effects of the Yakuza kick. Misaki elbow strike to Emma. Emma up against the ropes. Misaki coming out the other ropes. Forehead of steam and a clothesline over. Woo! And now that I can get some oxygen in my lungs, Emma sliding under our commentary desk with the force of that. Honey to her feet, only to find herself in a front face lock from Misaki Yumako. And I've been curious as to see Misaki Yumako's attitude coming into this, and it's mean, it's vicious, and just like that, rapidly striking knees to the face. Honey is just kind of out of it, kind of dazed, but Honey still absolutely bounds off the ropes, comes in, and they both. Oh, goodness gracious. Woo! Both knees, side of the head, down Misaki goes. Lifted up and a kick to the gut from to Misaki. Holy mackerel, that was just feet and face and cartwheeling and now sliding into that bridging pin. We've got one, two, and the matchbook does not get it. Oh, Emma coming in to break that up with a nice elbow drop. Misaki is up and outside the ring now. Emma picking Honey up. And I want to take nothing away from these two ladies. They have their history. They have their questionable history. And where both are very upstanding. Upstanding. Well, all of them are upstanding, but you know, we got the mean ones and the not so mean ones. Emma and Honey, not so mean, even though that was a really nice neck breaker from Emma. Emma is just none too happy with the Honey blunts. And an Irish whip sending Honey into the corner there. Misaki getting up on the apron, gets a rear naked choke on Honey from outside the ring. And offering Emma to hit Honey. Oh no. Gut punches to Honey from Emma, dropping her down, and Misaki steps back, kind of intelligently letting these two ladies work out their differences. Oh, Emma making it very clear there. She does not need Misaki's help. Well, I don't know which direction to go with this. I mean, oh, a nice snap suplex there. And Honey's feeling that on her back. And Misaki coming in, gonna sit down with Emma here. And they're just kind of staring at each other. Oh, wait, no. Misaki kicks her and rolls Emma to her shoulders, but only enough for a two count. Whew, boy, that was kind of confusing for my angle. I apologize about that. I don't know if anything was said to each other, but now Misaki in control, using that patience, that experience, that intelligence. That's Misaki Umaka, ladies and gentlemen. And, hold Emma up a little bit and a little away, keeping the distance. Oh, a nice distance suplex right there. That was good. And now we just got a pile of combatants right in the middle of the ring. Misaki first to her feet, very athletically. One of the most athletic females I've ever seen in the ring. Oh, gonna get her for a nice hooking of the leg. Got that outside leg. There's one, two, and oh, only a two count. Only a two. I don't know who rang the bell. No. That wasn't the bell. Jamie was just signaling that her shoulders were not down. Who rang that fucking bell? Hey, Arizona, why don't you be all CEO-like and go reprimand whoever rang that bell? That'd be great. Misaki grabbing Honey by the hair, lifting her up, and another rear naked choke. Oh, she drops it down. Now he's going to vine the legs around Honey's body. Emma crawling over towards the corner there. That previous barrage and assault showing the... And oh, there we go. Old rules. You gotta say a name. You got to say my name. Wait, no. Misaki's name, not my name. You got to say Misaki's name. Emma just barely stirring over there. Oh, okay, Morgan, then you are safe, I guess, from being hurt or pain or whatever. Actually, I can't say that. You're in the audience, and who knows what'll happen. But no, Jamie sees the hold. The hold is still legal.
Misaki calling for Honey to sleep well.
Oh, goodness gracious, a flying splash actually knocks Honey out of the hold like we're playing marbles here. She just knocked her out of the ring there, and so holy mackerel. Did you see the distance that Emma obtained there? Not height, but distance. Well, I do okay. I ranked 27th overall in regionals last year, so. Oh, now we got yet another just pile of combatants in the ring, all of them reeling from this match. And that's bound to happen, folks. I mean, everybody thinks they can go for like, you know, I go all night long, but no, you do about 5-10 minutes inside that ring, it's going to feel like 9 days. Okay, we got Emma stirring a little bit. Misaki's working through something over there. And then poor Honey's just been kind of the whipping post from both sides. And again, I can't reiterate enough. This Emma and Honey stuff, this is just two people working their stuff out in the ring, and I hope they get to work their stuff out. As Honey Buns comes back with an elbow and flings Emma towards the corner, Honey's backing up. She's rushing in, and oh, a nice elbow. Then round over Enziguri. Emma's reeling. Oh, using the boot to put Emma down, and now just stomping on Emma's chest. Looks like we got a frustrated Honey in the ring, and that is rarely a good thing. Honey, using that adrenaline, the spike of momentum, picking her up, and a Frankensteiner coming off the belt. Wait! Misaki grabs Emma in the pin! She's got her up! There's one! Two! Boom! Oh, that was so close! Honey, kicking right there to break the pin up. Oh, I thought that was over with. Misaki, ever the opportunist. Oh, that's just, there you go. Somebody said it in the audience there, Drewski. She is SL Wrestling OG through and through. Oh, wait a minute. I think they were, I don't know what they were doing. I don't know what game that was, but oh, shoves. And we got elbows. They're trading elbows. Getting the upper hand. Honey is frustrated, and I feel her frustration. I feel it. We got two opponents in the ring, you know, using you to just smack around. You get frustrated after a while. Honey flinging Misaki into the corner. She backs up. Wait a minute. She's calling for it. There's two. There's three. But oh, no. Come on. Honey is down in the Anaconda Vice. Yes, extra denied. Oh, poor Honey. She is trying to go for those ropes. But ladies and gentlemen, this is an official triple threat match. Those ropes are not going to help Honey unless she uses them as anti-leverage. And woo! Emma coming in. Basement dropkick right to Misaki's face. Crystal over there on the side. Crystal like that. It looks like Crystal is a fan of that. I saw a smirk. I saw Crystal smirking over there when feet hit face. So that's a, oh, wait a minute. Crystal's reaching in trying to help Honey out. Oh, now Emma poising Misaki into position. I'm not even going to worry about Honey on the apron there for the moment, though. She should keep at least some vantage point, some peripheral vision on Honey there, as Emma drags Misaki towards the center of the ring, damn near all the way across it. Misaki trying to get her bearings, but you know, you just had two pink boots. Emma flinging Misaki off the ropes, coming back for a super kick, another boot to the face. Oh, poor Misaki. Oh, she's probably going to forget all of, like, 3 years ago. Yeah, all of 2017 has just been wiped. Wait a minute. Emma grabbed the rope. Caught, turn, drop, hook. And there it is, the figure four leg lock. And Crystal's in the ring now. I guess Crystal wants to get a closer look here. She just wants to see.
Well, she wants to say something.
And she says it with her foot. Crystal kicking. Emma. Wait, what? Holy mackerel. I don't know. Honey is back in the ring. Still a little dazed, quite a bit of winded. The fatigue has set in. And we got at least one person that is not a fan of what Crystal did. I cannot say I applaud or condone that. Honey is up on the top there. She's coming up. She's flying, and she drops down on both of them. But it looks like Misaki might have gotten the most of that. Both women down on the mat, and oh, only a two count. Only a two count. Honey stayed there and laid down late. Honey, she's going to fling an arm over Emma. There's one, two. Oh, no. No. Oh, honey, just use your foot and put Misaki on her shoulders. That might work. I don't. Oh. Oh, there's so many pins. I'm sorry. I couldn't even keep up. There was one pin to Misaki, then one pin to Emma. Okay. Yes, and nachos. Honey, angrily grabbing Emma, now it looks like that, that beef that I had spoken of before coming into play here. Oh, honey just hanging Emma up by her own arm and head there. Great leverage from Honey Blunson. Oh, no! Oh, that red mist hitting Honey in the face. Crystal is back in the ring. Let's see if she joins Misaki. And no, Crystal's there protecting Honey. Oh, wait a minute, now she's back outside. Emma could not see that whatsoever. Emma doesn't realize what happened. Oh no. Oh. Go Crystal.
She's got attitude too. I like it.
Yes, Crystal says, you stop those cheap tricks. Crystal telling Misaki off, and oh, Emma with the heartbreaker in the ring. This match is still going, folks. Misaki directing traffic, telling Emma to finish it. Emma did. There's one, two, and three. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner via pinfall, Emma Gray. Saying, don't get involved in my business again, stupid girl. Ooh, Emma's got attitude, but unfortunately, Emma could only do what Emma could do because she didn't see the mist. She had no idea.
I mean, Colin, she can't see.
Oh, no.
Medical can look at her in the back.
Now, there you go, honey. There you go. Just follow the sound of Crystal's smirk. There you go. Well, folks, that was, wow, that was quite the match and quite the show. I'm going to toss out some links here for you to check out when you get a chance to. Absolutely.